Hello everyone, good afternoon. Now, most important concept we will discuss about isotopes, isobars, isotones, isodiapers, isosisters, isosisters we call that. Okay, just for our understanding. And one more important thing, and previously also we discussed that isoelectronic species. To understand all these things, first of all, how element have to represent. Element can be represented. Suppose element X. X is the element. For X, it is A. Here you have A and here you have Mr. Z. X is the element. And what is X here? I'll write. X is the atom of a particular element. Atom of a particular element. Simply we can call it as one kind of isotope which exists for a particular atom. And A is what? Atomic number. And Z is mass number. Mass number of a particular atom of a particular element, it will be fixed. Okay, mass number. Mass number, suppose I give you example. See, chlorine exists as 17 and 35, and chlorine 17 and 37. These two are existing in nature. So this is the mass of chlorine 35 isotope we call. This exists in nature. So why is it 35? Is it age of chlorine? No. It is just mass of a particular chlorine isotope what exists in what? In particular atmosphere. Okay, and this 37 is another isotope, okay, with 37 mass. Okay, two isotopes exist in nature. One is chlorine 35 and one is chlorine 37. Why 35 and why 37 is? Their masses exist like that. We cannot do anything and there is no formula to calculate this 35 and 37. Of course, to have an atomic mass, you have a different ways. Getting what I am saying? In some basic concepts of chemistry, we will understand how to calculate atomic mass. Of course, those also we will remember for certain elements. Okay, so here, this is the existence of chlorine in two ways. This is the representation of chlorine isotopes. Okay, chlorine exists in two ways. One is 1735 and 1737. This 17 is A. This 17 is what? Atomic number. What is this? Atomic number. This 37 is what? Mass number. Whose mass number? Mr. This particular chlorine. Okay. Chlorine also exists in another isotope with the mass 37. What is isotope? Everything we will discuss. No worry about that. Okay. So this is the representation of two chlorine isotopes, how they exist in nature. Okay. Next, come to the atomic number. What exactly atomic number? Atomic number is nothing but number of protons for any particular element. Any particular atom, how many number of protons are present? That is equals to atomic number. Atomic number also can be equals to number of electrons. Number of what, sir? Electrons. But when the atom is neutral, atomic number will never change for particular ion also. That's why I'm telling you atomic number is equal to number of protons. That is the best thing you have to remember. Okay. So here, suppose I'm telling you sodium and NaOH. Sir, actually electrons how many? Sodium means in previous we discussed that 11 electrons are there because atomic number is 11. Okay. Sodium Na+ means 10 electrons are there. But come to the atomic number. Atomic number, sorry, different, ulta. Atomic number is Z and mass number is A. Atomic number is Z and mass number is A. Small thing, I just written in reverse. And this is Z. Z is the atomic number and A is the mass number. Got it? So here, electrons 11 for sodium and for Na+ 10 electrons you have. and come to the atomic number. Atomic number will be 11, and here also atomic number will be 11 only. So atomic number means number of protons. Actually, number of protons is equals to number of electrons for a neutral atom. In this case, it's sodium, it's neutral, there is no loss of electron, right? So same way, there is no gain of electron. So sodium has 11 electrons itself, and sodium has 11 protons itself. Here, what you can say, therefore, electrons are 11 and protons are 11. Here electrons are 10 and here protons are 11. That's what I'm telling you very clearly. So for atom, what I'm trying to tell you, electrons is equals to protons when the atom is neutral. That will be equals to atomic number. This chlorine 17 here you have. Okay, so 17 protons you have. If Cl minus if you take, an 18 electrons will be there. So electrons can be changed, but protons never change, neutrons never change for a particular atom or ion. Electrons are involving in a chemical reaction, not proton. So loss of electron or gain of electron takes place, but protons will never share, protons will never lost, protons will never gain. Same way neutrons. Getting what I'm saying? Everybody knows that. I told you already, here this is the nucleus and these are the orbits, and this nucleus consists of protons and neutrons, and here you have electrons. These orbits consist of electrons. Means in orbits electrons will revolve. I was given already. So hope you understood all these things. So here I was given, ulta in previous. So Z is the atomic number and A is the mass number. Otherwise the representation is absolutely correct. So I was given atomic number is here. At base you have atomic number and mass number you have at the top. Mass number means what now? Atomic number means I was given already. What is the atomic number now? Atomic number is equals to number of protons or number of electrons for neutral atom. So simply atomic number is nothing but number of protons. You remember that one. So usually these representation for atoms only, not for ions. So definitely you can take those protons is equals to number of electrons, because the for neutral atom, what I said, for neutral atom protons is equal to electrons. Protons is equal to what, sir? Electrons. So number of protons is equal to number of electrons, you can say, for neutral atom. Got it what I said? So okay, next the most important thing is, what is the mass number? Mass number is A. Mass number is what, sir? A. Mass number means it is number of protons, number of protons plus number of neutrons. Neutrons are the neutral particles, protons are the positive particles. So mass number is equals to sum of the number of protons and number of neutrons. That is mass number. So two things I was given here. For neutral atom, protons is equals to electrons. Usually what we discuss here, atoms. Atoms means neutral atoms, neutral. Okay, for neutral atoms, protons is equals to electrons, that's what. So mass number you have a clarity. Okay, next, how to have number of neutrons, number of neutrons for a particular X, it is Z and this is A. Here for this particular X atom, what is the number of neutrons? E is nothing but very simple, A minus Z. Simply you can say number of neutrons is equals to mass number minus atomic number. Atomic number, that's it. Or atomic number means what? Number of protons or number of electrons, that's it. So mass number minus atomic number, you can get number of neutrons present in a particular atom. Atoms are belongs to element. Hydrogen atoms are belongs to hydrogen element. The quantity representation is atoms. How many atoms? 1 mole means Avogadro number. Avogadro number, everything we will discuss in future. Okay, Avogadro number means 6.023 into 10 power 23 atoms. One mole of atoms we call. That mole concept is our next class. Hope you understood all these things. So, what is what are the three points here I was given? For neutral atom, protons is equal to electrons. And for neutral atom, mass number A is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. So this will be same for anything. And number of neutrons means A minus Z. Number of neutrons means what, sir? A minus Z. Mass number minus atomic number. Okay? So, where electrons are present? In orbits. Electrons will revolve around the nucleus in circular paths, which we call orbits or shells, I told you. And protons and neutrons are present in nucleus that I was given. Now, let's see what exactly isotopes. Okay, so isotopes means atoms of elements which have same atomic number. Means isotopes are belongs to same element. Okay, but what will be the different means? Same atomic number but different mass number. Isotopes have same atomic number. Atomic number is same but different in mass number. So if you want example, I'll give you this. As I was given already, this chlorine is a 17 and 35. Here I can write 35, or that side also I can write 35, not a problem. And chlorine 17 and 37. So what you have, same atomic number, see, 17 and 17. These we call isotopes. What will be the difference? This is base, sir. What this is? Base we can call. And this is called top or topi. Top. So isotope. So top will be different. Topi will be different. Topi me garbar. Topi is 35 and 37. Like that you can remember. So this top will be different. In that name all you have. Isotope. Top. Topi me garbar. Garbar means different. So chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. And here you have a 17, here you have a 17. And here you have a top 35, here you have a top 37. So where you have a difference in this? Here you have a difference. Atomic number same, mass number different. So they are called isotopes. Like that, one more example you can have. 1H1, 1H2 and 1H3. So what these are? Radioactive. 1H3 is tritium, is radioactive. Okay, what is radioactive thing you understand? These are the isotopes of hydrogen element. So hydrogen have a different atoms in different kind. It is 1H1. 1H1 is called protium. 1H1 is called what, sir? Protium. This is a deuterium. What is this? Deuterium. We represent with a D. This is a tritium. T. Radioactive, this one. Okay, so what you have to understand, isotopes means, so topi means top. This topi will be different. 1, 2, 3. Base will be same. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 1, 1. Okay, so this is about isotopes. Isotopes means species having same atomic number but different mass number, we call isotopes. Hope you understood. So this is about isotopes. So many like this you can write. It's having same atomic number and different mass number. Like the 6C13 and 6C14. What these are? Isotopes. Nothing. You have no need to buy hard examples. Sir, I remember 10 examples for isotopes. Enough, sir. No need. Simply you have to identify. Isotopes means okay. Topi different. Base same. They are called isotopes. So this is about isotopes. One more example for isotopes. Next, let's see isobars. isobars. Isobars means here also same story. Having same mass number. So bar means what is the meaning? Base will be different. Okay. So having same mass number but different atomic number. They are called isobars. What they are called? Isobars. You can have some example. Argon 1840 and calcium 2040. So 18 is a base. C. Base different. Topi different isotopes. Base different isobars. Okay. So here, see, this will be different. What I was round up, those are different. Atomic number different, but mass number, see, mass number 40. Okay, mass number means, I told you, protons plus neutrons is equals to mass number. That exists in nature, what you can say. Getting what I'm saying? So here, what are the number of protons? Here protons are 18, here protons are 20. What will be different, they'll ask you. In isobars, protons different, electrons different, neutrons different. What different? Okay, like that they'll ask you. This proton is nothing but atomic number, Z or protons. Okay, and electrons how many? Here 18. Here electrons how many? 20. Because I'm considering neutral, because no charges I'm representing here. And come to the neutrons, it is A minus Z. This Z is, sorry, before that, what is the mass number? Mass number here 40, here mass number is 40. So here you have a 40, here you have a 40. Hope you understood. So here what will be the number of neutrons? Number of neutrons we represent with N. Neutrons N, electrons E, protons P. Got it? So neutrons is 40 minus 18. Here, neutrons is, what sir, 40 minus 20. 40 minus 20, because what I told you, number of neutrons, A minus Z, I told you already. Neutrons is equals to A minus Z. Okay, so this is about isobars. Like that, you can have many examples. Having what? Same atomic number and different mass number. They are isotopes. Okay, suppose like this, if I am giving like this, uranium 92, 235, uranium 92, 238, what these two are, isotopes or isobars? Like they will give you, you have to identify, okay sir, 92, base is same, okay, topi, gadbad, topi different, so isotopes, topi different, isotopes, base different, isobars, that's it, okay, you have, many examples like this. Okay, having same atomic number but different mass number isotopes. Having same mass number, different atomic number are called isobars. Next we have isotones. Isotones, ons, ens, nos, means number of neutrons are same. Species means atoms having same number of neutrons. Same number of neutrons, but different atomic number, different mass number. Both are different. Which are different? Atomic number is different and mass number also different. So species means here what, the atoms having same number of neutrons but different atomic number and mass number. Both are different. Atomic number different, mass number different. Only the number of neutrons are same. Those kind, any examples sir, means very simple. See here, some potassium 39 and 19, and here you have some calcium 20 40. These two are the examples. I'm giving one example, it's enough, because as I told you, have no need to buy a single example. Just you must know the particular definition. Isotones are okay. Tones, uns, ens. Okay, neutrons are same. N, this N, if you remember, neutrons are same. Simple, just for remembering. Okay, so here, how you can say? Again, same story. Atomic number is 19. Here, atomic number is 20. Atomic number is nothing but protons. Protons or atomic number. And come to the mass number. Mass number is 39 here, and here mass number is 40 here. Number of neutrons here, 39 minus 19, which is equals to 20. Here number of neutrons, 40 minus 20, because 40 minus 20 or this change, and number of neutrons you will have 20. So here number of neutrons 20, here number of neutrons 20. Number of neutrons same, but atomic number different and mass number different. They are called isotones, ens. Okay, number of neutrons same, neutrons ens same, they are called isotones. Hope you understood. And this is the example for what isotones. Okay, you can have many examples like that in our assignment also. It's not a problem because we will solve some questions also. Okay, so it's not a problem. Come to the next isodiophers. Isodiophers, listen carefully. Isodiophers means species having, species means again the same story, species having same difference in n minus p. This n minus p difference will be same, means number of neutrons minus protons difference will be same. Okay, that is what isodiophers. Isodiophers means what is the meaning? Having same difference in neutrons and protons, that difference will be same. Okay, let's see some simple examples. Boron 511, carbon 613. So same, first you write down protons how many, protons 5. Okay, here protons how many, okay 6. Here neutrons how many, neutrons write down, neutrons how many, 11. Okay, here neutrons are, Z. P is Z. Sorry. And mass number how much? Mass number is 11. Here mass number how much? A is 13. Got it? Now, next is number of neutrons. Number of neutrons means how much? 11 minus 5. Number of neutrons are 6. Here, number of neutrons how many? 13 minus 6. Right? So here, 7. 7, correct? 7. N minus P difference how much now? N minus P. So 6 minus 5, how much? 1. Here N minus P, 7 minus 6, which is equals to 1. So here N minus P is 1. Here N minus P is 1. Hope you understood this. So isodiophers means species having same difference in N minus P. Simple, sir. N minus P value will be same for particular species. N minus P, what the difference you are considering, that N minus P value will be same. They are called isodiophers. N minus P value will be same. They are called isodiophers. Hope you understood. Isodiophers means having same N minus P value. I'll give you one more example without wasting time. Example 2. Uranium 92 to 30. Uranium 92 to 38. And thorium 90 to 35. These two examples, let's see. How many protons you have? Protons are 92. Here protons how many? 90. Neutrons, how many? Neutrons, neutrons. Mass number, no need to write, directly write on. 238 minus 92. So, I think 146. Not I think, I am very sure. It's a... Okay. It's 234. Here, number of neutrons, how many? 234 minus 90. So, you will have 144 you will have. Correct? 144 you will have. And what is n minus p? N minus p I am taking now. N minus p. 146 minus 92. I think 54, right? 54? Yes, 54. Here n minus p. N minus p is 144. N minus p. 144 minus 90. So here also 54 you get. So what you have? N minus p value 54, N minus p value 54. So uranium 92-238 and thorium 90-234. These two are examples of isodiophers. Very important for you. Okay. So maybe here 235 written means it's not a problem. We have no need to buy hat. That's why I was written 235 or what. Like simply I'm telling you here examples they'll give. Or you have to identify. Getting what I'm saying? For simple way, I'm telling you, here you have to consider N minus P value will be same. That is for isodiophers. For isodiophers, two examples I was given. Okay? Notes is very important. You have to write down notes carefully. Now, let's see the last and final for us. That is what we call isosters. In that name only you have isosisters. Means why we call isosisters, just for remembering, because they appears like that, because the species or molecules or particular, maybe some, these are for molecules only, molecules or some ions with more number of atoms, maybe like NO2 plus, like that also you can consider maybe sometimes. So here what will be same for isosters having same atom, having same number of atoms and same number of electrons, total number of electrons will be same. I repeat here, species having same number of atoms or molecules having, simply use like this, molecules having same number of atoms and same number of electrons, they are called isosters. So what I can say now, molecules, I am writing molecules in general, but maybe for ions sometimes, molecules having same number of atoms, same number of atoms and same number of electrons, same number of electrons are called, what they are called isosters, isosisters, we call simply. Without wasting time, I will give you example, some carbon dioxide, CO2, and here Mr. some N2O, these are called isosters. How I will tell you? Number of atoms, how many? Number of atoms. One carbon, two oxygens. Three. Here also, three. Number of atoms. Number of atoms, here three and here also three. So, atoms will be same because one carbon, two oxygens. Here two nitrogens, one oxygen. Number of atoms, what atoms I have no need to consider. So atoms are same or not? Yes, number of atoms are same. Here three atoms are there, one carbon and two oxygens. Here two nitrogens and one oxygen. So number of atoms will be same. Come to the number of electrons. Number of electrons also must be same. Then only we can call them as isosters. So here carbon atomic number how much? 6. Two oxygens means, one oxygen means 8. Two oxygens means, otherwise I'll write no problem, 18 into 2. So 6 plus 16, so 22 electrons are there, number of electrons. Here number of electrons how many? Number of electrons how many? Two nitrogens. 2 × 7 because nitrogen you know already. That's why I was explained electronic configurations first. Nitrogen atomic number is 7, so 7 electrons, 2 nitrogens, 2 × 7 and plus 8 because oxygen 8, okay, so 14 plus 8, so here also 22. So number of electrons here 22, number of electrons here 22. So what I told you, number of atoms same, number of electrons same, number of atoms same, number of electrons same, they are called isosteps. Isosteps. Okay, so this is what I told you. Isosteps means molecules are having same number of molecules. One another. Okay, molecules having same number of atoms and same number of electrons are called isosteps. Got it? So what we discussed today: isotopes, isobars, isotones, isodiapers, isosteps. Okay. Next, isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic means previously, as I told you, atoms I told. For molecules also you can say. I will give you simple example here. CO2 and N2O. These are isoelectronic as well as isosteps, because atoms are same, electrons are same, because I told you, that's why I am not giving isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic means what I told you previously, same number of electrons if there, they are called isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species means only for atoms we have to consider? No, for atoms, for ions, for molecules also you can consider. That is isoelectronic. Sir, isoelectronic means there is any need to have same number of atoms? No. If same number of atoms also present, then they are also called isosteps. One more example, you will have a clarity. H2O, NH3. Electrons, if you see, electrons 2 plus, because 2 hydrogens, 1 hydrogen means 1 electron, 2 plus 8, total 10 electrons you have. Here electrons, nitrogen 7, hydrogens 3, here also 10 electrons. These two are isoelectronic. What is that? Isoelectronic, but not isosteps. To have a difference, I was given this example finally. So what is isosteps? Means you have a clarity, I think so. Isosteps, some species wanted to become isosteps, means they must have same number of atoms and same number of electrons. But isoelectronic species means if they have same number of electrons, enough. Getting what I'm saying? Now these two are isoelectronic. These two are isoelectronic. But these two are isosteps. But these two are not isosteps. Why these two are not isosteps? Here 2 hydrogens, 1 oxygen. So number of atoms 3 here. 1 nitrogen, 3 hydrogens. So number of atoms are 4. So here you have a different atoms. That's why these two examples are not isosteps. These two are not isosteps, but they are isoelectronic species. But these two molecules are isoelectronic as well as isosteps, because we discussed just previously. Okay, so number of electrons are 22 22, and number of atoms are 3 and 3. Hope you understood all these things. Thank you very much, and practice all these things, and you have to write down notes, and you have to send in our WhatsApp group all these things what we discussed.